Hi everyone, today we are going to be making a keychain, and I'd like to start by telling you the sizes of your fabric you will need. You're going to need two strips of fabric that are 14 inches long and just about 2¼ inches wide. So if you measure, mine's cut out with pinking shears, but it's just over 2¼. And again, the width can vary between 2¼, 2½ inches is fine, depending on how wide you'd like your keychain to be. You'll also need a 3 by 3½ scrap of fabric for the clasp at the top. So let's go ahead and get started. First thing we're going to do is we're going to practice sewing a standard seam. So looking at my settings, I have my needle at, it's centered and it's at a 0 width, 2½ length. So we're gonna sew a straight stitch. I'm going to take my strips of fabric and put them right sides together so it is inside out. And go ahead and pin both ends first, making sure they're perfectly aligned. And then I'll do the middle. Now I'm going to line up at 5/8 inch and begin by doing a back stitch, a few stitches to the end, and then I'm going to continue sewing along the full length at 5/8 inch. And if your machine doesn't have a marker on it, I can certainly add one for you with tape, or you can just look at that first long line. If your thread ever gets stuck here and it feels taut, just wiggle the hand wheel and it should release it. Pull out your thread and remember to clip both ends close to the fabric. So that's our first step. The next thing I'm going to do now that I sewed this together is iron it or press it. So first you can start by just using your fingers to open up the seam, and then you're going to use the iron and just kind of, I'm not even resting the iron yet, I'm just opening it up with the nose. It's very hot, so be careful. And now I'm going to, as I get it so there's no puckers or bubbles on the other side, I'm going to give it the full weight of the iron. Okay, so now it's pressed open. Now we're going to interface it. So this is interfacing. It's a white non-woven fabric. It's kind of fused together and it has little dots on one side. You can barely see them, but you can feel them. And those dots are actually an adhesive. And when it is heated up, it will melt and make it stick to your fabric. So it'll also stick to the ironing board. So it's very important that before you iron it, you trim any pieces that are sticking out so that it's just on your fabric. This ended up being 14 inches by just under 3 inches. It's okay if it's not perfect, but it should cover most of the area. This is a pressing cloth, just a piece of white cotton fabric. And I'm just going to hold and press this down for about 15 seconds. It doesn't take very long. And just keep moving. I'm not sliding back and forth. I'm literally pressing down so that it adheres. You can let go. Just don't forget about it. About 15 seconds. And then you can always double check what is sticking, what isn't sticking. So the whole thing seems pretty stuck. So it looks like this. Now I'm going to fold the fabric evenly in half just to help it know where to go. So you can scoot your iron along as you fold, but ironing on this project is, and all projects, it's equally as important as sewing. Because if it doesn't look crisp, it's not folded evenly, it's not going to look very good. So I'm pressing it in half. Again, pressing, not sliding, because if I'm sliding, I'm going to probably mess it up a little bit. The next step, so it's okay if it's not perfectly wanting to go that way. It's got a lot of structure now, and that's what that interfacing does. It provides structure and it helps it be a little bit stiffer and not as flimsy. Now we're going to fold our fabric in to the middle. And by doing that, that will kind of show you the total width we're going to get to. If you wanted your keychain to be wider, you could fold it less. But for mine, I'm going to put it directly to the middle. And that's kind of nice because I can see the seam still right here. And I know where to meet the fabric. So again, I'm going to practice pressing and just take your time. The iron is nice because it's your third hand. You can set something up. As long as you don't leave it for too long, you can press and you can come over and press again. And the fabric will listen eventually, but it is springy, so you might need to add some pressure, even some pins to help it stay where you want it, because as you can see, it's springing back. That's okay, as long as I have gotten a crease. So it is springing back. I'll give it a little more on this end, but we have to do another fold. So just make sure it's touching, it's where you want it to be. This step is critical. After that, one more fold. So for this, it wouldn't be a bad idea to get some pins, because after this, you will need a couple to hold it in place. So I'm going to fold it one more time. You can see your edges even, and press. Try not to slide. Give it a little pressure. Slide to the next part. I said don't slide, and then I said slide. So move to the next part. And again, it might not stay, but are we getting it to crease? That's important. So then you're going to put a few pins in perpendicular. So this way, trust me, it will be easier to sew. So like this, down a little bit and then through, and then we'll come to the middle. And you might not be able to tell, but feeling it, it's nice and thick, which is really what you want for a good wristlet keychain. Next step, since I'm over at the ironing board anyway, I'm going to prepare my scrap piece for sewing later. So I'm gonna take the longer edge, it's slightly longer, and fold it about 1 inch. I have an inch pretty much memorized in my head, but it doesn't hurt to measure. In fact, I want you to measure. And then this side should go almost all the way. So you don't want the raw edge, that cut edge, to show. So just fold it again. What we really want is this little band that will eventually wrap around the keychain. And if it isn't even, adjust that fold. It doesn't have to be exactly 1 inch. It can be as thick or thin as you want, but you don't want it to be uneven or have a raw edge. So eventually it will wrap around something like that. Okay, so I have my pressed and interfaced 14 inch strip, and now I am going to do what's called an edge stitch or a top stitch. So if you want your thread to stand out, mine is blue right now, that's fine. It's blue on the top, it's white on the bottom. Most likely for yours, you'll either want it to match or you'll want it to at least be the same on the top and the bottom. For my demo, I'm okay with it. So I'm going to start by placing this toe off the edge of the fabric. So the inner part of this is lined up with the edge, and that will give me that 1/8 edge stitch. My stitch length is still at 2.5, and I'm going to back stitch. it's okay if you want to just pivot to the other side. You could also stop, backstitch, and go again. And you notice I'm adjusting a little bit. If you're not ready to pivot, you can adjust, do another stitch or two, and then turn. All right, that is how you edge stitch your band. I'm gonna cut my threads, make sure you did backstitch. And now you have this very secure and thick piece of fabric ready for the hardware. Okay, so now the fun part. We're going to take our lobster clamp, that's what they call it, and slide this on like this, just anywhere, kind of in the middle. And then next, your D-ring, if you choose to use it for another spot so we can loop around. And that's in place. Now we're going to join the two ends together using a zigzag stitch. So this way we can practice our zigzag. You're going to move your width all the way over to a 5. We're going to put our ends together so they are touching, and put your presser foot down right in the middle. See that little groove is in the middle of where these two are lining up. And you're going to, you can start by hand if you want, go back and forth. And yes, I want to backstitch, but I'm going to backstitch a lot. So I'm going to go backwards, forwards, till I get it pretty secure. And then I want you to just keep doing that. It takes a little finessing. This could be a good part where you get a partner to help you. But I want to make sure that it is very much joined together. So I'm just going forwards and backwards several times. So then I've done that. It's almost all the way secured, but I can see a little gap. So there's nothing wrong with doing it a little bit more. So I can flip over to this side so I could see a little bit better and join it a little bit more. We don't want the keychain to break, so sew it away. Okay, I think that's good. I'm going to trim my threads really nice. And now I have a circle for my keychain, but I also have this unsightly looking part. So we're going to slide this around. I'll zoom out so you can see. Slide this around like so, so that this is here. And slide your D-ring down. Flip it around so it's on the outside, like this. This is where you decide. Do you want this to be your outside or the other side? I think I like this. I'm going to put this stitch section here, and now this is where this guy comes in. So I'm not sure I'm thrilled with how wide it is. I think I want it to be narrower, and that's where you can adjust it. You can go back to the ironing board and you could make it that narrow. As long as it is covering your stitch line, so I kind of like that better. As long as it's covering your stitch line and it is not showing any raw edges, it's even, then you are fine. So I'm going to go adjust that to make it just how I want it. Okay, I folded it a little thinner, and now I'm going to show you how I got it to look like that. So taking this piece of fabric, kind of trying to hold everything, I'm going to cover that zigzag stitch. I'm going to tuck each of those raw edges in and under. Now a pin might not hold this in place so beautiful like that. Slide it down, no zigzag showing. Pin might not do it, but a binder clip or a clothespin could if you need it. And if it is too bulky, I'm afraid mine might be a little too thick, we can open it up and we can thin it out so it's not so many layers right here. So do that if you need to. Okay, so we're ready to sew this. We're going to make sure we switch back from a zigzag to a straight stitch. And you're going to line up like you're doing an edge stitch again. And we're just going to sew over this from right above it to right below it. So a little back stitch, right below it, little back stitch. And I just punched it with my finger because a pin was not going through. But like I said, a clamp would be fine too. I'm gonna do it from the other direction, making sure that is tucked in nicely. Don't want it sticking out. Get it just right. It's the very last step, so take your time. Tuck it in. You can tell just now with that sound that it's too thick for the machine and the feed dogs are getting stuck. So you can, if it feels like it can handle it, actually use the handwheel to get through that thick spot and then you should be good to go. And there you have it. That is how you make a keychain. You're gonna trim up your threads really well. And then you're all finished. It'll look just like that.